Many people have chronic pain caused by muscle spasms, muscle tension, and myofascial pain. There is a group of medications called muscle relaxants. Some examples are Flexeril, Norflex, Xanaflex, Soma, and Robaxin. Some of them can be bought without a doctor's prescription. Do they really work for muscle pain? Is there any difference between them? Is it one better than the other? Are they harmful to the body? Is it okay to use them with alcohol? Will I get addicted to them? So, let's talk about muscle relaxants today. Skeletal muscle relaxants are a class of medications that are used to treat muscle pain. These are types of pain caused by overuse, poor posture, muscle tension, sprains, and strains. These medications act mainly in the brain. They don't do much to the muscles itself. That's why one of the most common side effects is sleepiness. All of these muscle relaxants cause sedation. I'll mention some drug names in this video, but this video is not sponsored by any maker of muscle relaxants. Here are some muscle relaxants that are available in Canada without a prescription. Methocarbamol, Robaxacin, Methocarbamol mixed with acetaminophen, Robaxacet, Tylenol back pain, Methocarbamol mixed with ibuprofen, it's called Robax Platinum, Orphenadrine, Norflex, Orphenadrine mixed with aspirin and caffeine is called Norgesic Pro. Chlorzoxazone mixed with acetaminophen is called Back 8 Forte. Then, there are the muscle relaxants that require a doctor's prescription. Cyclobenzaprine, the brand name is Flexeril. Metaxalone, Skeletal. And in other countries, there are other skeletal muscle relaxants like Carisoprodol, the brand name is Soma. It's no longer sold in Canada because there is a high risk of dependence and abuse. Before I continue, let me remind you that this video is not intended to replace medical advice. It's for educational purposes only. If you need medical advice, contact your doctor, and in case of emergency, go to the nearest emergency department or call an ambulance. Do muscle relaxants really work for muscle pain? Yes, but for short-term pain relief. Actually, these medications do not act in the muscles. Their effect is in the brain. They reduce the brain activity that controls the muscles. If the person has muscle pain, muscle spasms, or myofascial pain, I prefer them to use massage, heat, tense, and exercises. I have a video where I demonstrate how to use a foam roller to treat muscle spasms. It's much better than taking a pill of muscle relaxant, and it does not have any side effects. Cyclobenzaprine and orphenadrine have been shown effective for pain relief in acute low back pain. There is no data about their prolonged use, and there are concerns that they may have serious consequences like drowsiness, fatigue during the day that could cause falls, motor vehicle collisions, or work-related injuries. They may also interact with other medications that the person is taking. Tizanidine needs a doctor's prescription, and it's not better than the other muscle relaxants. It is associated with liver and cardiac side effects. All muscle relaxants cause sleepiness, and that may be an indirect reason why patients like to use them. But it does not mean their sleep is better or higher quality. Well, muscle relaxants are relatively safe to the stomach, liver, and kidneys. If the person uses them during the day, they have to avoid operating a heavy machinery, driving a car, or operating any function that can cause harm to themselves or anyone else. If the person uses muscle relaxants with alcohol, there is an increased risk of sedation. And if they also take opioids or benzodiazepines, there is an increased risk of overdose and death. People with acute back pain should not take these medications for more than 3 weeks. Older adults should avoid taking muscle relaxants because of the increased risk of sedation, cognitive impairment, falls, and fractures. Muscle relaxants can be abused, and people can develop dependence and tolerance if they use them daily for a prolonged period. There is some confusion even among medical professionals about another group of drugs called anti-spasticity drugs. Spasticity is a problem that is caused by a neurological disease that affects either the brain or the spinal cord. Spasticity is characterized by increased tonus, hyperreflexia, and weakness of the muscle. The medications that are used to treat spasticity are different from medications that we use to treat muscle spasms. The medications used for spasticity are Tizanidine, botulinum toxin, baclofen, dantrolene, and benzodiazepines. The antispasticity medication should only be prescribed when there is hypertonicity, such as after a spinal cord injury, stroke, multiple sclerosis, cerebral palsy, or brain injury. So if you like this video so far, press the like button below and watch my next video here. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel here too and turn on the notifications button. Goodbye!